Hello, I'm Alan Peatfield. Welcome to our test shop here at Heathfield. This is a Startrite H330MV. You'll see lots of Startrite machines out there. Some of them are grey like this, some are green, the earlier ones. They've been out of production for some years, but there are thousands of these around. So I want to go through some of the things to look for and how to put them right on this machine, because this is typical Startrite. And the same things apply to this as, say, the H250M and the H225M and some of the automatics, although the automatic machines have a roller feed system to feed the material through. So I'll just go through a few of the things that you must look for and how to put them right if you can. Obviously, the fan wheels, check them for rock this way. Make sure you take the blade tension off, or take the blade off completely and get hold of that and see if there's any rock on it. The other end, see if there's any rock on that, and also a little bit of backlash is acceptable, but if there's a lot of backlash, if that moves an inch or so, the gearbox is probably spent. The blade guides, I'll show you how to adjust those and how to fix them in a minute. I'll take one of the guide arms off. The bridge here, which is set at the factory, can be used to adjust the machine, but I'd rather you didn't do that, because it's been set at the factory and there's probably something else wrong rather than anything on here. They go to the trouble of actually sealing these screws off with silicone sealant to stop people monkeying with that end of the machine, because usually if there's a problem, it's either a blade problem or a guide problem here. So you only touch that as a last resort. Really, you should leave that to me. Okay, I've taken the guide arm off the machine. It's the only way to work. Don't try doing this with the guide arm on the machine. You'll only end up in trouble. Get a clean workbench so you can see what you're doing, and if you drop anything, you can pick it up. The carbide tips here, which guide the blade, do wear out, so it's a good idea to replace them. Obviously, you can take them off with these screws, but there are some little conical nuts inside which you won't be able to buy from a hardware shop. So when they fall out, at least you'll be able to find them if you've got a clean bench. Ball bearings here, which are easy to get hold of. If you can't find them, just phone me up. I've got them in stock. Behind these ball bearings, on these attachments, there is a pill of carbide which the blade will rest against. Obviously, as you're cutting through the work, there is a thrust from that carbide pill. That also ought to be replaced, especially if it's got a groove in it. The groove in it will work hard on the back edge of the blade and cause you snapping problems. So all you have to do is replace those guides. Then there's a pinch screw here which you can do up until the blade is just a reasonable transitional fit in there. Not that it's snagging in any way, but so there's absolutely no rock in the blade. Right, this end of the machine, there's several things you've got to look at. One of them is, a lot of people don't know this exists, but this is a little, like a feeler gauge that goes in there when the blade is correctly tensioned. I'll just take the tension off, and you'll see it doesn't go in there now. So always use that, tension the blade up until that goes in the slot. These screws here are for tracking the blade. That is to say, you try and get this adjusted so that the blade isn't scraping on the flange of the band wheel. So it's just clear if possible. That makes a huge difference to blade life, and also will stop wearing the flange away from the machine if you've got it adjusted right. Hopefully that's okay. It was set at the factory, but it may have moved a bit over the years. But you can see there's a jacking screw there and the locking screws there. But you only have to move it, say, one flat at a time to make quite a big difference. Down here is a screw which is adjustment for the counterbalance weight of the machine. That's to say, the weight of this bow at the moment is quite heavy. And we've set it like this because at the moment the machine is set for cutting stainless steel solids. So we need quite a lot of head weight for penetration. If we screw that screw right in, as far as it goes, this head is much lighter. And it then makes it much better to cut thin fabrications, box sections, that sort of thing. So that it's there for a purpose. If you can get it down to about £15 for fabrication work and £25 for stainless, that's good. You can actually use a fishing scale, you know, one of those spring balances hanging on the bandwheel will give you an idea of the head weight. Okay, the hydraulic cylinder here is a bit small for this size machine, and it has plastic pipes, which means that there is a certain amount of bow bounce on this machine you really can't avoid. But if you can't get the bow right up to the top, it's usually because there's not enough oil in this cylinder. You can either take those little countersunk screws out and fill it up with an oil can, which I find rather irritating, or you can actually unscrew this cap. There's a little hole in the side so you can put the right kind of round bar in to unscrew that, lift that cap up and literally pour oil in there until it's full up, screw it back on, and then you're done. The cylinder will work again. Right, this is the variable speed arrangement. I've taken the belt off, it needs to be replaced. It's easy to get a new one on, you just pull this out and you can feed the belt over there and get it in. It's a bit of a tug, but you can get it on no problem. As you can see, that slides in and out to give you a different speed. And it's all done with this arrangement here. There's some numbers on there, but they don't really relate to anything. So the best thing you can do is check the blade speed by marking it with a white paint dot and timing how many times it goes around in a minute. You know how long the blade is. And try and correspond it with, say, 30 meters a minute for stainless steel and 80 meters a minute for mild steel, for instance. If in doubt about blade speeds, please contact our team. We're only too pleased to help with the materials that you're cutting for some advice and the right blade to use. On the cheaper machines, there are just step pulleys, just like you have on a cheap drilling machine. You just move them up and down the pulleys according to the speed you want to cut.